Hi, Steve Bousquet, the lawn science guy, here today with American Landscape and Lawn Science, and I'm talking about moss today. We get a lot of calls. People are freaking out about moss. What do I do? There's moss in my lawn. Well, it's the end of March. It's very early spring. The lawn has not been growing for the past 3-4 months, so moss is kind of filled in and taken over a little bit in these yards. Now, a lot of people think, well, I have moss, that means I have low pH, I need to lime. Well, this moss right here that came from a backyard, I'm going to continue with more information on this in the video. This moss came from a lawn that had a perfect pH of 6.8. I have the soil test right here. It has optimum calcium, optimum magnesium. The pH is almost perfect, and yet we have moss. Well, that's because the yard is very shady. It's a very wet, damp yard. Water runs through this yard, and it's a perfect condition for moss. The moss is a wonderful thing, actually. Moss is Mother Nature's way of protecting the soil. It's not hurting the lawn. And by the middle to the end of May, you'll almost not even see the moss. You won't notice the moss. The moss is not hurting anything. It's not hurting your lawn. It's not hurting your lawn mower. And people just should leave it alone. A lot of people will get out and rake really hard and get blisters and work very, very diligently to clean the moss up, and then it grows back. Yeah, because it's almost impossible to get all the moss, and it will continue to grow during the periods of the year that it's getting the support to grow. So just leave the moss alone, feed your lawn like you would, encourage the lawn to fill in, thicken, develop deeper roots, and leave the moss alone. It's Mother Nature way of protecting that soil. It's really doing us a favor, all of us a favor. If you don't have the moss there in the winter time, you would have erosion, you would have rutting, big grooves and dips in the lawn, and that would just create more work with soil. So one of the things I see people do, they rip all the moss up and then they seed. And the grass comes up, it looks good for about a month, and then it dies off. Well, the grass root only is going to be developed down an inch or two before the summer months hit it. And that's why that grass dies off. It's too immature to make it through a hot summer. So just leave the moss alone. Don't rake it up. Just pick all the big sticks off your lawn, and when the grass is ready to mow, cut the grass. Just leave the moss alone. It's not hurting anything. And it's a lot of effort and work that people do to get rid of something that is not doing anything. It's actually very, very beneficial. So again, this is what the moss looks like. I'm sure everyone's familiar with what moss looks like. It grows. It's okay. It doesn't hurt anything. Just leave it alone. And then by the middle of March, middle of May, you're not even going to realize that it was there. The grass is going to thicken, fill in, especially if you're on a lawn science program where the lawn's being fed properly and at the right times and the right amount of nutrients. So, I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to our channel and give it a thumbs up in the video in the YouTube box there. And if you would like more information about our company, I'm going to put a link below where you can just click on the lawnscience.com link and get a hold of us. Or if you have questions or like more information about moss or your yard, you can reach me at 860-642-9966.